Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta, and welcome back to Risk of Rain 2. Today marks a glorious day in the Risk of Rain 2 series as we're going to be beginning our daily runs here, as you can tell by the fancy schmancy new thumbnail. Thank you, everybody, who's been showing constant support for the Risk of Rain series. And I figure, what a better way to start a brand new series than on a Friday, of course, because it's the weekend, everyone's got no plans. Well, at least, I guess all the non-cool people do, or maybe the cool people do have no plans. Ah, there's a one. There's a noodle scratcher for you. Anyway, so what this is going to be, basically, I'm going to be starting down from the left to right, going in the classes. Today, we're going to be doing a commando run, then eventually go to multi, huntress, engineer, artificer, and then the mercenary, who I don't know how to unlock yet. And I know I could go and look to see, like, you know, hey, how do you unlock the mercenary? But I think it's better if I just figure it out. I think it has something to do with the rusted keys. Don't quote me on that though, because I'm just firing off the cuff because I still don't know what those dang things do. But I've been loving Risk of Rain 2, and I think that a lot of people have also been enjoying it here on the channel. I mean, if you look at the first impressions video, that video very quickly became my most watched video of all time as far as the time is concerned. Like it didn't take the Risk of Rain first impressions video to hit 100,000 views in no time. It did that in 4 days, which is incredible. So thank you all very much, and thank you for everyone who's been subscribing to the channel as well. I really do appreciate it, and I hope that you're excited to see more Risk of Rain 2 content as we follow the game's development and really dive in here. And what else can I say about it? It's sort of scratched an itch that compliments Isaac in a way that I want to play both all the time. And, you know, I don't know what that says about me. I mean, I guess I just really like roguelike games, which is true, because, I mean, if you think about it, like, that's the whole nature of the roguelike genre, is that no two runs are the same, you know. You can have similar-looking runs, for sure, but you're not going to have the same, you know, looking run every single time. Unless you get Mom's Knife. But, hey, we're just saying. First item is going to be War Banner here. We did pick up the Ocular HUD, by the way. Ocular HUD's going to give us guaranteed crit strikes for 8 seconds every time we activate it. It's very good for the commando just because of how fast he attacks. Obviously, we're going to be looking to try to get some offense here, getting more crits. We want to have, like, say, tri-tip dagger. Ukulele is also very good. Gasoline can. All that stuff is great. And, of course, attack speed as well. What is that down there? That looks like a sticky bomb. Sticky bomb is actually quite good for the... it's quite good for the commando. We have another 3D printer over here, which looks like it's got a med kit, which we don't necessarily want. It's kind of hoping that Ocular HUD will come back here. I am going to play a chant shrine one more time. Now, I have a little bit of a statute of limitations when it comes to chant shrines. The more that I play on the late night stream, and I've sunk about almost, I'd say, 35 hours into Risk of Rain 2 since that first impressions video first aired. The more that I play, the more I realize that chant shrines, there has to be a limit. You can't just blindly sit here and be like, oh, I sure hope that the shrine pays me off. Like, eventually, yeah, of course, it's going to pay off, but at what price? And the answer is at the price of your entire freaking run, because the game will make sure that it makes you waste a whole bunch of money on chant shrines, and it won't care. The longer and more time that you waste on chant shrines, the greater the chances that you're going to get kind of screwed. I'm going to trade War Banner and trade the stun grenade for a sticky bomb. Sticky bombs are actually, again, quite good. With the commando, and something that you need early on, and this is sort of you're going to be hearing me talk a lot about making a lot of comparisons to Isaac, and I'll try to limit that, because I understand that some people may not even know what the Binding of Isaac is, or you don't watch it, which is understandable, and I'm still going to try to articulate all my thoughts and reasonings behind the choices that I make, and admittedly, most of them probably won't be the right choice, or the min-maxy choice, but hey, that's not why you watch me, at least I hope not, because I'd be greatly disappointed. That's if the reason why you watch me is to get some min-maxy ideas here. That's I got bad news for you. I'm gonna be getting Monster Tooth anyway. That's gonna go ahead and drop a health orb. I am gonna trade it in for another sticky bomb. The most important thing for the commando is you want on-hit attacks. So it's not quite as important as for, like, say, the huntress, because obviously she's got an amazing special ability in her lightning glaive, her storm glaive, whatever the heck it's called. But the on-hit chance for the basic attack for the commando is very, very important. And if you can reliably stack one or even two sticky bombs per shot, that's a lot of extra damage than when they go off. And it does scale very, very well with your level. And the first time that I looked at sticky bomb, I was like, I don't really know if it's like a great item. Ooh, armor-piercing rounds. Hey, that's going to do more damage to bosses, which is fantastic. The first time that I saw sticky bombs, I was like, you know, it's kind of okay, I guess, but I don't really see the practical use. Turns out, after, you know, 30-some-odd hours later here in the game, sticky bombs are actually really good. Get the Lensmaker glasses, going to give us 10% crit per stack. Crit's always nice. Of course, I would love to get a Predatory Instinct Hunter headdress. So I'm going to go ahead and skip this turret. I was trying to jump up there. Now, that is one of the downsides. Ooh, found a rare chest over here. That's one of the downsides of the commando is that he's not, yes, he's mobile, but he's not reliably mobile in the sense that, like, he can't teleport. He can't sprint away like multi-can. You know, he doesn't have a bubble shield or anything like that he can hide behind. He's just a dude with a gun. I think that's the reason why I kind of like the commando. Fun fact, this is also the first commando run I've played since I think the follow-up video. I may have played him one or two more times since then. I don't remember, though. Okay, teleporter's here. We're just about out of here at 5 minutes. I do want to make sure that we don't miss anything, like missing another rare chest would have been real bad. And we get the Wax Quail. So the Wax Quail, this is an item that I literally just unlocked in the late night stream. And essentially what it does, it gives you a little power boost as you see your tier jump whenever you jump while sprinting. So this can be very good because what it does is it gives you the ability to dash out of the way. It's sort of like a tactical role in that sense where you can just say nope on out of there. I'm not going to use the Ocular HUD because we're about to go fight the boss, but I am going to use the stun here. You see the amount of damage that the Sticky Bombs do. The ukulele, by the way, that guitar that you see up there, the rare guitar that we picked up, that will do the Chain Lightning effect. Sometimes you'll see it chain off. Let's see if we can get one to proc here. It's very good for clearing packs and also just deals good damage. It kind of proc there, but it's hard to tell. Let's see if we can get one closer. Let's go ahead and fight the boss as well as we're approaching the 6 minute mark here. Not a bad first floor. We've got a lot of offense. It's exactly what we need. There's the Chain Lightning that you saw right there. Maybe Beetle Queen. She's pretty much, I think, widely considered the easiest boss to start off with. So I am going to pop the Ocular HUD, and go ham here. Yeah, there we go. No problem at all. The Sticky Bombs would have finished her off. So there's the ukulele charge on this Ice Champion here. We get Bandolier. Bandolier is actually quite good for the commando. What the Bandolier will do is every now and then you'll see a little box pop drop down. It looks like a drop from Anthem or from the Division. It's a crate that drops. And what that does is it will reset all your cooldowns. And as you can imagine, being able to spam your stun over and over again is very, very good. Saw the Chain Lightning there again coming in from the ukulele. So very good first floor here. Offensively speaking, we've got a good run here. Now we don't really have a way of healing ourselves, but that's sort of secondary, all things considered. I mean, much like Isaac again, the best defense is a good offense, and that is, especially holds true in Risk of Rain, Risk of Rain 2. There's a crate over there. That's just a currency cache. There you go. So you see the bombs there, they hit for 106, 96, and we can stack multiple ones if we get our attack speed high enough. So not a bad first floor here, I gotta say. First world, I should say. Did you see the Sticky Bombs also do an AoE explosion as well? We'll head on down to the next world. 7 minutes down, looking good. Whoa there! Let's go ahead and take that easy there, Beetle Guard. There you go, you saw that big 288 damage explosion from that second Sticky Bomb. On this level, there's usually almost always a Newt Shrine up there. It doesn't look like... actually, is it there? It looks like it's there. It's not highlighted yet by the lighting engine. Alright, so the Acrid Wastes, or the desert, I just call it the desert level. Basically, this level is pretty good for open world fighting, for bosses especially. It's nowhere near as bad as the swamp area. This is what the bandoliers look like, and again, that resets your cooldown as soon as you pick it up. So if you get enough of them dropping, you can effectively spam your ultimate ability quite often, almost like constantly. And for the commando, that's very good because that's a ton of crowd control, which is something that he does not have a whole lot of. That being said, though, we actually got hit by Tara, I think. That being said, though, the commando is surprisingly tanky. Go ahead and use Wax Quail here to get a little bit of oomph in our step. Should be able to jump over this, no problem. Yeah, there we go. All right, what kind of splendorous items do we get? Oh, we have ourselves the Tri-Tip Dagger. Tri-Tip Dagger is going to give us that little bleed effect right there, that red number that you saw pop off of that lemur, which I still just call them lemurs because I feel like that's what they are. The lemurs, if they were giant lizards that breathe fire, sure, why not? These guys. There you go. So, yeah, the tri-tip dagger is going to give us a dot, a bleeding over time effect that can sometimes hit. And again, given the frequency that the commando attacks with, it's very good. It's very, very good for damage. It's really good for all the classes, except for, again, maybe the Artificer. She plays a little bit differently, as you all have seen. I've done a couple more runs with her since the last class spotlight that I did on her yesterday, or day before, whenever that was. I think it was yesterday. And I like her. She's definitely a spellcaster, I will say that. And another thing that I'll say is extra magazine is incredible on her. So what the extra magazine is, and it'd be nice if we actually, well, I guess it's not that big of a deal if we get one of the commando. I mean, being able to spam your secondary ability would be neat, but, you know. But for the Artificer, it's almost, I would say, like, a requirement to get empty magazines as much as possible. Because with that, you can throw out the charged Nova Bomb over and over and over again, just do massive amounts of AoE damage. Whereas the commando, yeah, I mean, I guess you can get single target damage, and, you know, if they're lined up nicely, you can have piercing damage. But for the most part, it's kind of incidental damage. I mean, your main source of damage is going to be your basic attack. Energy is going to give us sprinting speed. So again, a little bit more mobility. That is one downside of the commando, is that while he's not exactly slow, he's also not exactly like graceful. You know, again, the reason why I like him, he's just your average regular Joe. You know, he's a dude with a gun. He's not sure why he's here, but all he's trying to do is stay alive and not get horribly murdered by a bunch of beetles and flying wisps and aliens, that sort of thing. Arnold Bobble is going to give us a spider bite effect or a slowing effect every time we hit, or at least have a chance to slow him on hit anyway. You see the little temporal chains, that right there, that little, it looks like a little like web wrapping. That's what the slowing effect is. We also picked up Will-O-Wisp, of course. Will-O-Wisp is going to do that living bomb effect, that little fiery explosion when anything dies. That can actually chain to other things, which also can chain to other things as well. So Will-O-Wisp is very effective at clearing large rooms very quickly. Okay, see Ukulele just procking all over the place, along with all the sticky bombs just going off on the Beetle Guard. All right, we got Sun Grenade. Sun Grenade's not terrible. It's not bad. I wouldn't mind a little bit of defensive items here in the forms of healing. You saw me activate the ocular HUD. That's when I have guaranteed crit strikes for the next 8 seconds. And that's the best time to just start wrecking shop. Now, unfortunately, Bandolier does not reset your item cooldown, as I think that might be a little bit broken. As fun as it would be, though, yeah, that's a little bit broken. All right, so we're going to bunny hop our way out. Apparently the wax coil goes on our head. I never even noticed that before, I don't think. But people have been asking me, who is my favorite class, or who is my favorite character to play as? Honestly, it's still the Huntress. I've had some of my best runs with her, and I actually had my best run. In fact, the run that I actually unlocked the wax coil was with the Huntress. And it was a run that I had 21 attack speed syringes, which was insane. Now, talking about the attack speed debate for a moment, and it's not even really a debate, because we confirmed that there is no cap. There is absolutely no cap on attack speed. And what I talked about, I believe it was in the Engineers video. It may have been in the multi video. Is that a lunar? Oh, it is a shrine. Yeah, you know what? Let's pay one coin. Let's see what we can get here. Or no, it's not. It's not a shrine. I was going to say, that's a weird place for the new shrine, but turns out it's not. Anyway. Someone had told me in Twitch chat one evening that there was a 14 stack limit on attack speed, and I never truly believed that because it's only just one person. You can't go off of the saying of just one person. No offense to that one person if they are listening. I don't even remember who it was, but I have confirmed that there is no cap on attack speed. Furthermore, the attack speed the reason why they said 14, I think that what they were talking about was the achievement that you get to unlock the predatory instinct, which was very easy to unlock. Essentially, all you gotta do is just find a 3D printer that has the attack speed syringe or the soldier syringe, and there you go, bud. We get fireworks. Fireworks are essentially going to fire out a bunch of missiles every time that we open up a container. Doesn't matter what it is. Doesn't matter even if it's a shrine, it will still send out a bunch of heat-seeking missiles. We get fuel cell. Fuel cell is gonna give us an additional charge on our equipment. Also reduce the cooldown, which is great. More crit's always better. completely whiffed there on the straight shot. But I think that's going to do it for this floor here, as we spent almost 8 minutes on the floor. But we got, this is good though. We have 5 stacks of sticky bombs. I probably don't want too much more past that. If we could swing a couple of syringes, that'd be awesome. And we'll just see how far this run can go, you know? That is one downside, potential downside that I see to the Risk of Rain series, is the fact that they are going to run very, very long, especially if we're really rocking and rolling, or if I'm taking my time and, like, exploring everything. I'm going to try to limit the amount of time that these episodes take, because obviously I don't really want to talk for another hour and a half every single day on top of what I already do with streaming and Isaac and stuff, but that's not going to stop me from doing the series. I just have to I have to measure myself. And not in that way, you freaking, I know how you work, internet. There's the Clay Dune Strider. I'm trying not to get run down here by the tar balls. We're gonna get shot by the wisps. I'm trying to sprint and dodge as much as I can. I gotta stop firing in order to do that. Let's get the wax quail going. We were down to 1 HP. We still might die, by the way. I'm gonna bunny hop and run around while we try to heal up. We don't have any healing at all. The only healing we have is our built-in healing. There's a chance shrine here. I didn't realize that. There's the chest over here as well. Okay, so we have to take down, I need to make a mental note of this. We need to take down the Clay Dune Strider. I think, like, I'm not worried about taking down the boss. It's the wisps that are the problem, which is usually the case. And actually, the wax quail is really helping us out here, because that allowed us to get away. I needed to remember I'm not playing the hunters. So I'm going to bunny hop my way out of here. Definitely need to stop to take down the wisps, because they will stop our health regeneration, and they almost killed us. I'm surprised that I didn't die, to be honest. Yeah, we hear the wisps. We got to take them out. Got hit by the Bugle Guard. Sounded like he was behind me. Now, those explosions you hear, that's the Clay Dune Strider trying to kill us. There we go. That's what I want to see. I want to see the wisps die before they get a chance to do anything. Now, where is the Clay Dune Strider? That's what I want to know. I'm going to pop the ocular HUD here just to help us clear. You'd think that it'd be impossible to lose a giant walking octopus pot. I'm going to bunny hop my way out of here. Actually, a really effective way of getting around here. I'm impressed. I've not used the wax quail before. I mean, everything is, even the wisps are having a difficult time keeping up with us, which is good, because again, we were almost dead there. But we need to find the Dune Strider. Staying alive is only going to keep us, you know, horizontal for so long. And by horizontal, I mean vertical. We don't want to go horizontal. The whole point is not to go horizontal. All these freaking wisps, man. Completely whiffed on the shot there, but that's all right. We took down all the wisps. That's all I care about. Where in the world? There he is. What the heck you doing all the way over here, you goof? It's been like 30 years since I was over here. There you go. Big time crits there. You saw that from the ocular HUD. Now, I am going to come back to this room. If I can, I will come back and open up that the chance shrine along with that other chest. As much as I harp on about offense, it's definitely important to have a little bit of healing here. So we get the Hoppa Feather, which is okay. It doesn't help us with... It doesn't help us with healing, of course, but it will help us with mobility. But we need healing, though. Like, Leech Seed is also is great for the commando. Sprint, you idiot. Okay, the teleporter's open. So, we're not going to go through the teleporter quite yet, because I want to get to this chance shrine over here. The Hapu feather, or the Hop-Up feather, I like to call it, will give us an extra jump in the air for every stack that we get. It's very good for mobility. And overall, it doesn't seem like it works. It doesn't look like it works on the second jump in the air with the Wax Quail, but it's all right. Look at that. We get an attack speed syringe here. Totally worth our time. We also get another tri-point dagger. We get gasoline as well. That's so good. What a... That was as scary as it was to get down to 1 HP. I'm glad it happened because it just gave us a huge boost in our offense. Okay, let's get out of here before it gets too crazy. We're already at 20 minutes now. We're just now leaving World 2. That's not good. Now, I'm not saying that we're going to win every single run. I mean, technically, you can't win every single run. Every run, you will eventually die. It's just a matter of how horrible and when. All right, let's get on out of here. We accrued a fair bit of money. It's going to be almost another level. Yeah. Oh, so close. All right, level 11, here we go. Pop the Aku HUD immediately because we don't want to mess around in this level. Again, be mindful. You want to make sure you're using your tactical roll as often as possible. Don't give the game a chance to get an easy kill on you. You want to always be moving, unless, of course, you're stopping to heal, which we don't know what that means, but I will say in this game, in Risk of Rain 2, much like everything else, the best defense is a good offense, like I was talking about earlier, but some defense also doesn't hurt. You just don't want too much defense, and that's really one of the worst things. That's the worst type of run to have in Risk of Rain 2, whenever you feel like you've got a great start, but as the run progresses on, you just get nothing but defensive upgrades. Like, you get nothing but, like, med kits and, like, you know, cautious slugs and bustling fungus, that sort of thing, speaking of which. I mean, a slug every now and then, fine. Super happy about that. I am very happy, and I can't be sarcastic about it. I'm very happy that at least we have some form of healing right now. It's just that when you have nothing but slugs is when things happen. We got Mr. Wise Guy over here. Now, as you see right there, I cannot stun the Greater Wisp, but luckily I didn't have to because he's dead. Our damage is really starting to come through here. Now, I will say that the Commando late game scales very, very, very well. Assuming you have the attack speed and assuming you have the proc on hits to facilitate like a ton of damage like we do right now, you're going to start seeing us blow some stuff up pretty quickly and pretty fast. You get a crowbar here. Another bandolier. Don't really want another bandolier, but we've got three of them. And trying to get to 130 here. I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time, or at least I'm going to try not to spend a whole lot of time on this floor. Because we need to catch up. We should have already been out of here, to be honest. Us running away for 10 minutes against the Clay Dune Strider didn't help us out. Another crowbar. Hey, happy to have it. More damage to healthy enemies. Enemies spawn in healthy, so it's good to be able to kill them, burn them down quickly. There we go. Shoot a sticky bomb right on his butt. That's right. Came out the exact way that I wanted it to. That also came out the exact same way. Okay, all right. It's episode one here. Kind of. All right, so they have a stun grenade 3D printer, which is not great. I mean, crowd control is great, I guess, if you need it, but like, we don't need it right now. Right now, all I'm looking for is rare items. Hopefully we get a legendary item, that'd be nice. A little bit of healing, infusion would be great. We get a second stack of Lensmaker glasses, which is gonna increase our crit. If we can find a Predatory Instincts, that would be awesome. Because we've got a decent amount of crit here. especially with us having the Ocular HUD as well. Bunny hop out of here. I'm essentially not going to stop and fight until we're just out of money. So did we get extra magazine? Extra magazine's fantastic for the Artificer. Mando, I mean, again, it would be nice to be able to spam our secondary ability, the piercing shot, but it doesn't do that much damage, at least not that I've seen anyway. There's a rare chest up here. Get another Uke. Very happy to have that. The ukulele is going to give us a nice little boost to our damage as far as our chain damage goes. There we go. Okay, there's a new shrine here. I don't know if I want to open it, though. We only have two. I would only hope for the double damage trinket, but even then, is it really worth a lunar coin? No, you know what? It's episode one. Let's spend a coin. Let's see what we get. And we get the Effigy of Grief, which is not good at all. Now, some people were saying that the Effigy is actually quite good. I don't like it. Effectively, what it does, it puts this giant bubble on the ground that severely limits the movement speed of anything, including yourself, that gets caught inside of it. The AoE, the area is huge on it. So it is good for crippling bosses, I suppose, but it's not necessarily the sexiest item that I want right now. You saw what we just did to that the stone golem. Bustling fungus. I mean, we do kind of need a little bit of help here, but I'm not worried about it. Gotta be careful with these wisps here. I did hit the 50% shrine. Health shrine gives us that red shrine that you just saw. It does give us money based on how much money, based on how much blood we give it. I will go for a tough love here. Tough love is gonna act like sort of like Mask of Infamy from Isaac. For those of you who are familiar with that item, it will periodically nullify and totally mitigate attacks or really any damage. It could be even falling damage. I've had it proc on. I think that we are about done here. We're already on very hard. We're about to go to insane. Just want to make sure you don't miss anything. That's not a crate. That's just a air duct that you can use to jump up. We don't need to worry about that. There's also a guaranteed... there's a guaranteed Newt Shrine up there. For those of you who have a bunch of Lunar Coins and you're not sure what to do with them. Gonna check one more area for a chest here. Okay, there's a cache and no chest. Okay. Go medkit. Gonna receive a delayed heal upon taking damage. It's okay, I suppose. It's not the greatest. It doesn't really like effectively cancel out a whole lot of damage, but it's okay. Better than nothing. Might as well open this equipment. Might as well see what it is. It's going to be Magma Worm. Magma Worm is not a good fight for us. So the Magma Worm is annoying for a couple reasons. It's not a particularly hard boss. It's just that you have to be careful because it can teleport right beneath you. Oh man, you see all the chain? Did you see all the wisps, the will-o-wisps there? Chaining like that? That's crazy. But... something that I pointed out on the stream, I've been pointing out for a while now, is that I do feel that fire damage is slightly overtuned. I think that they need to scale it back a little bit. And of course, the Magma Worm has nothing but fire damage. So you can imagine what happens whenever it lands on you. But you see the amount of damage that we have now, and all those will-o-wisps chaining like that from the sticky bombs. We've got a very strong run. It's a very basic run. Nothing too incredible about this one, but get another hop-up feather. Sure. Take that. Lunar coin here. See there, you are allowed to roll in the air as well, even though that doesn't make a whole lot of sense. The Magma Worm had no prayer. We lit him up with the Ocular HUD, and then the rest was history. Explosive first episode here of the Daily Runs. Fancy schmancy new title. The thumbnail made by Lili. Make sure you go check out my artist link down below. She does very good work. Very talented artist. I'm lucky to have a suite of talented artists that I can pull from and get good thumbnails made. Well worth the money, in my opinion. We didn't die, by the way. That was the death rattle from one of the champions, so we will probably die here. I'm gonna at least try to do one loop for this episode. Surprising lack of drones. We have not seen a single drone. Or at least if we've seen them, I didn't see them. This looks like a fireworks 3D printer, it looks like. Yep. Hoping it was attack speed. You talk about some of the downsides of the commando. I guess it's not really a downside of the commando. It's more of a downside if you're a scrub like me, is that his damage is very precise. You know, with the Huntress, you can be lazy because she's got the auto-targeting from the arrows and stuff. You can't do that with the commando. If you miss your shot, you miss all your damage. Another cautious slug. These slugs are getting out of hand now. I feel like I'm playing FTL for a little bit. But the beauty of Will-O-Wisp, especially Will-O-Wisp, is the fact that we only have to hit one target to hit them all. It's sort of syringe. There we go. Second stack of our attack speed. Now we're cooking. I mean, well, we probably are actually cooking because it looks like it's pretty hot and sweaty down here. Very sulfury. There we go. Fireworks doing the work here. We got another cautious slug. Heard the squeaky toy go off. That was from Tough Times. Lots of chests here, oriented right next to where we spawned, and I'm fine with that. Whoa! Hello, Imp Lord. This isn't even the boss of the level here. Didn't know that he was teleporting on us. Thanks to Tougher Times helping us out and mitigating some of that damage. So you can see the sticky bombs just constantly going off. Right now, verticality is our friend. Our ultimate. We're just gonna keep on circle scraping here. Open up a crate. Try to get a little bit of help from the fireworks. Can't even see what it dropped yet. It looked like bustling fungus, but I'm not 100% sure. Woo! There we go. Look at the chain reaction. Will-O-Wisp. Yeah, it was bustling fungus. That's okay. We needed a little bit extra source of healing. That was a lot of money that we just made. Of course, we did murder just like half of the entire. So when we finally get a drone, hello, healing drone. I'm not going to open the equipment cache because, honestly, I'm pretty content with just having the ocular HUD. Now, of course, the dream item for the commando and many other commandos is the Beautiful Behemoth. I think it's called Beautiful Behemoth, where it's one I talked about. Wow, got another stack of Sticky Bombs. It's one I talked about, I believe, on the Engineer video, where essentially all your attacks turn into explosions. And that was also part of that Huntress run I was talking about earlier, the 21 times attack speed run, which unfortunately can't be shown on YouTube because it was a late night stream and I wasn't doing any talking, and I played copyrighted music just because I love listening to metal while I play Risk of Rain 2. Risk of Rain 2 and metal go hand in hand like peanut butter and jelly, man. It looks like one of the best cutting edge music videos of all time with everything, especially when we're in World 4 with everything Excel shaded and dark and fire and all this stuff. Looks metal as all get out. Oh my goodness, and that is an attack speed. That is an attack speed 3D printer. Oh yes, we end this. We end good here, boys and girls. So even if this kills us, I just want to show you what happens when you get like 20 attack speed syringes. I think that's a good start for the series here. Now, I don't recommend this. For the record, I do not recommend giving away all your white items that you meticulously planned out and acquired throughout the course of your run just because you want attack speed. But to show you how awesome attack speed is on the commando, especially the commando, this is a great opportunity to do that. So what I'm doing right now, for those of you who don't know, I'm trading all of our white items. Every white item we have, or common items, they're guaranteed to turn into syringes, attack syringes. The attack speed syringe, I should say. Soldier syringe is the exact name of the item. And effectively, we're turning our basic attack into a minigun, as you can see right here. We're already at 13 stacks of attack speed here. I mean, we look like we're multi on, like, crack right now. Like, this damage is just going to get crazier and crazier. I'll go up to 20. I probably won't go too much past that, because I do want to, like, actually survive and kill this boss. And I don't know. I don't have a whole lot of limit when it comes to, you know, whether or not, oh, we should just end it after one loop or whatever. I don't know. We'll figure it out. To be honest, we'll probably end up dying because we have given away a lot of our survivability. Although we still have two cautious slugs. Anyway, what I'm doing here is I'm strafing back and forth. Oh my god, strafing back and forth and just trying to get as many attack speed syringes as possible. There we go. We'll go to 21. This matches my highest ever amount of syringes. All right, so we got 21 times the attack speed, which is good. We've got plenty of money because we were murdering everything that stood in our way over there. Let's go check this equipment cache here. I was hoping we could find the legendary cache over here, but it turns out it's not. I mean, look at the damage. Yeah, and we definitely want the ocular HUD. If we're going to stick with this amount of attack speed, we need the ocular HUD. The ocular HUD. Yeah, it looks like we have a minigun. It's great. All right, let's put this to work. I'm pretty sure that we missed a lot of chests here, but let's just see what happens. Don't Titan. It's either not going to be fun for us or it's not going to be fun for you. Either way, it's going to be fun for everybody. Well, I thought that I could get behind that side over there. I thought there was a nook and cranny over here that I could line of sight that, but then it turns out, oh no, it's just a dead end. Anyway, good first run. It's a shame we didn't get to see that again, but I'm sure that we'll find another attack syringe 3D printer. But yeah, if you want to see more of Risk of Rain 2, let me know in the comments down below. Also, by clicking the like button, tells me a whole lot if you want to see more Risk of Rain 2 content here. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.